This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Baku Commune, Centro-Caspian Dictatorship, Armenian Revolutionary Federation, United Kingdom, White Russians, Commanders and Leaders, Nuri Pasha, Mersal Bey, Grigory Korganov, General Dukuchayev, Colonel Avatisov, Lionel Dunsterval, Hamazasp, Sr. Vanstian, Strength, Islamic Army of the Caucasus, 14,000 Infantry, 500 Cavalry, 40 guns, 6,000 regulars, Baku Army 6,000 to 9,151 infantry, 40 guns, Dunsterforce 1,000 infantry, 1 artillery battery, 1 machine gun section, 3 armored cars, 2 Martinside G-100 planes, Bicharakov detachment, 600 casualties and losses total, 2,000 Baku Army, British Empire. 200 VE Caucasus Campaign, Bergman Offensive, Sarakamish, Ardahan, Van Manzikert, Kara, Kilis, Erzurum Offensive, Trebizond, Bitlis, Erzincan, German Expedition, Sardarabad, Abiran, Karakilisa. Baku Associated Articles, Dunsterforce, Nurperforce, VE Southern Front of the Russian Civil War, Kharkiv 1917, Kiev 1918, Transcaucasia, Baku 1918, Donbass, Don, Kuban 1 Step March, Iasi, Don, Crimea 1918, Kuban 2. Saritsyn, Voronezh, Poverino, Ekaterinoslav March, Northern Caucasus 1918-1919, Ukraine 1918-1919, Odessa, Nikolaev, Ukraine 1919, Grigoriev Uprising, Vyashenskaya Uprising, Mamontov Raid, Counteroffensive of Southern Front Advancing on Moscow, Nizhyn, Poltava, Kiev January 1919, Odessa 1919, Alexander Fort, Kiev August 1919, Kiev December 1919. Kapyor Don, Kharkiv June 1919, Kharkiv December 1919, Pavlograd, Ekaterinoslav, Donbass 1919, Rostov, Novorossiysk, Odessa 1920, Northern Caucasus 1920, Baku 1920, Anzali, Ulagai, Landing, Azov Sea, Northern Taurida, Makhnovshina, Tambov Rebellion, Perekop, Chongar, Georgia, The Battle of Baku, Azerbaijani, Baki Doyu Su, Russian, Bitva Zaba, Turkish, Baku Maherbesi in June. 8 External links, background, further information, Persian campaign and Caucasus campaign, further information, March days, the Ottoman Caucasus offensive in 1918, in 1917, the Russian Caucasus front collapsed following the abdication of the Tsar on 9 March 1917, the Special Transcaucasian Committee was established to fill the administrative gap in areas occupied in the course of the war on the Caucasian front by the Russian Provisional Government in the Transcaucasia. This administration, which included representatives of Armenian, Azerbaijani and Georgian groups, did not last long. In November 1917, the first government of the independent Transcaucasia was created in Tbilisi and named the Transcaucasian Commissariat, also known as the same following the Bolshevik seizure of power in St. Petersburg on 5 December 1917. This new Transcaucasian Committee gave endorsement to the Armistice of Erzincan, which was signed by the Russians with the command of the Ottoman Third Army. Russian soldiers mainly left the front and returned to their homes. A number of Russian troops left for the Persian campaign, contrary to the rules of the armistice. General Nikolai Baratov remained in Hamadan and at Kermanshah. A Russian colonel named Lazar Bicharakov remained with 10,000 troops. Both forces were supplemented by British liaison officers. In 1918, the British invited the Armenians to hold out and picked officers and non-commissioned officers to form an advisory force, organizing them under the command of Lionel Dunsterval at Baghdad. It was named the Dunsterforce. The military goal of Dunsterforce was to reach the Caucasus via Persia. While the Persian campaign was active, the British planned to organize an army to be recruited from the Armenians and other pro-Allied elements that still existed in the Caucasus. On 10 February 1918, the same gathered and made the decision to establish independence. On 24 February 1918, the same proclaimed the Transcaucasia as independent under the Transcaucasian Democratic Federative Republic. The Transcaucasian Commissariat was anti-Bolshevik in its political goals and sought the separation of Transcaucasia from Bolshevik Russia. On 27 January 1918, the British mission Dunsterforce set out from Baghdad with officers and instructors to the region. Dunsterforce was ordered to keep the Caucasus Tabriz front intact and put a stop to Enver Enver Pasha's plans on 17 February, Dunsterforce arrived at Enzeli. Here they were denied passage to Baku by local Bolsheviks, who cited the change in the political situation on 3 March 1918. The Grand Vizier Talat Pasha signed the Treaty of Brest-Litovsk with the Russian SFSR. The Treaty of Brest-Litovsk stipulated that the border be pulled back to pre-war levels and that the cities of Batum, Kars, and Ardahan be transferred to the Ottoman Empire. Between 14 March to April 1918, the Trabzon Peace Conference was held between the Ottoman Empire and the delegation of the same on 30 March 1918, the 10th day of Trabzon Peace Conference, the news of the internecine conflict. The oilfields of Baku, the control of the Caspian, would open the way to further expansion in Central Asia, and possibly British India on the 11th of May 1918. A new peace conference opened at Batum. At this conference, Ottomans extended their demands to include Tiflis as well as Alexandropol and Ekmeadzin, through which they wanted a railroad to be built to connect Kars and Julfa with Baku. The Armenian and Georgian members of the Republic's delegation began to stall beginning on the 21st of May. The Ottoman army moved ahead once again. The conflict led to the Battle of Sardarapat 21-29 May, the Battle of Karakilis 1918-24-28 May, and the Battle of Bash Abran 21-24 May. On 26 May 1918, the Federation dissolved initially with the Georgian Declaration of Independence, Democratic Republic of Georgia, quickly followed by those of the Armenian First Republic of Armenia, and Azerbaijan Democratic Republic representatives on 28 May. On 28 May 1918, Georgia signed the Treaty of Poti with Germany and welcomed the German Caucasus expedition, seeing in the Germans protectors against the post-Russian Revolution havoc and the Ottoman military advances. The government of Azerbaijan moved from Tiflis to Ganjik or Ganja at the same time. Germany turned to negotiations with the Soviet Russia and offered to stop the Islamic Army of the Caucasus in return for guaranteed access to Baku's oil. They reached an agreement on 27 August whereby Germany was to receive a quarter of Baku's oil production. The German government requested that the Ottoman Empire delay any offensive into Azerbaijan. Enver Pasha ignored this request in May. On the Persian front, a military mission under Nuri Pasha, brother of Enver Pasha, settled in Tabriz to organize the Islamic Army of the Caucasus to fight not only Armenians but also the Bolsheviks. Nuri Pasha's army occupied large parts of the Azerbaijani Democratic Republic without much opposition, influencing the fragile structure of the newly formed state. Ottoman interference led some elements of Azerbaijani society to oppose Turks on 4 June 1918. Azerbaijan and the Ottoman Empire signed a Treaty of Friendship and Cooperation, Clause 4 of which held that the Ottoman Empire would provide military assistance to Azerbaijan, if such assistance was required for maintaining peace and security in the country. Prelude. The Ottoman Islamic Army of the Caucasus was under the command of Nuri Pasha. It was formed in Ganja. It included the Ottoman 5th Caucasian and 15th Divisions, and the Azerbaijani Muslim Corps under General Ali Aga Sheklinski. There were roughly 14,000 Ottoman troops with 500 cavalrymen and 40 pieces of artillery. 30% of the newly formed army consisted of Ottoman soldiers, the rest being Azerbaijani forces and volunteers from Dagestan. The Baku forces were commanded by the former Tsarist General Dekuchayev, with his Armenian Chief of Staff, Colonel Avadisev. Under their command were about 6,000 Centrocaspian dictatorship troops of the Baku Army or Baku Battalions. The vast majority of the troops in this force were Armenians, though there were some Russians among them. Their artillery comprised some 40 field guns. Most of the Baku Soviet troops and practically all their officers were Armenians of Dashnak leanings, and often outright Dashniks. One of the Red Army commanders was the notorious Amazasp, who had fought as a guerrilla leader against the Turks, and for whom any Muslim was an enemy simply because he was a Muslim. The British mission, Dunsterforce, was headed by Major General Lionel Dunsterville, who had arrived to take command of the mission force in Baghdad on 18 January 1918. The first members of the force were already assembled. Dunsterville set out from Baghdad on 27 January 1918, with four NCOs and batmen in 41 Ford vans and cars. The British troops in battle under Dunsterville numbered roughly 1,000. They were supported by a field artillery battery, machine gun section, three armored cars, and two airplanes. He was to proceed through Persia. Began from Mesopotamian campaign through Persian campaign to the port of Anzali. Opposing forces. Dunsterville far left with Dunsterforce staff. Members of Dunsterforce training troops of the local Baku Army. Armenian units drilling in Baku. Murad of Sebastia lead his volunteers and died at the Battle of Baku. Ottoman Islamic Army of the Caucasus passing through Kazakh Battle North Staffords, a contingent of the Dunster Force, on the road to Baku. Armenian troops in a trench outside city of Baku on 6 June 1918, Grigory Korganov, People's Commissar of Military and Naval Affairs of the Baku Soviet, issued an order to the Red Army to begin offensive operations against Ganja. Being unable to defend the independence of the country on their own, the government of Azerbaijan asked the Ottoman Empire for military support in accordance with Clause 4 of the treaty between the two countries. The Baku Soviet troops looted and killed Muslims as they moved towards Ganja. However, many of the troops Shahumian requested from Moscow for the protection of Baku did not arrive because they were held up on the orders of Joseph Stalin in Tsaritsyn. Also, on Stalin's orders, grain collected in northern Caucasus to feed the starving people in Baku was directed to Tsaritsyn. Shahumian protested to Lenin and to the military committee about Stalin's behavior, and he often stated, "Stalin will not help us." Lack of troops and food would be decisive in the fate of the Baku Soviet on 27 June to 1 July 1918. In the battle near Goyche, the Ottoman Islamic Army of the Caucasus defeated the Red Army and started advancing towards Baku at this point. Earlier in June, Bicharakov was in the vicinity of Kazvin, trying to go north after defeating some Janglis. He proceeded to check the situation in Baku. Returning on 22 June, he planned to save the situation by blocking the Army of the Caucasus at Alyati Pristan. However, he arrived too late, and instead went farther north to Derbent, planning to attack the invading Army of the Caucasus from the north at Baku. He left only a small Cossack contingent beside the Russians. The Janglis also harassed elements of the Dunster force going to Anzali on their way to Baku. Once defeated, the Janglis dispersed on reaching Anzali in late July. Dunsterville also arrested the local Bolsheviks who had sided with the Janglis on 26 July 1918. A coup d'état overthrew the Bolsheviks in Baku. The new body, the Central Caspian Dictatorship, wanted to arrest Stepan Shahumian, but he and his 1,200 Red Army troops seized the local arsenal and 13 ships, and began heading to Astrakhan. The Caspian fleet, loyal to the new government, turned them back by the 30th of July 1918. The advance parties of the Islamic Army of the Caucasus had reached the heights above Baku, causing Dunsterville to immediately send contingents of his troops to Baku, which arrived on 16 August. On 17 August 1918, Dukuchayev started an offensive at Diga. He planned for 600 Armenians under Colonel Stepanov to attack to the north of Baku. He would further be reinforced by some Warwicks and North Staffords, eventually taking Novokhani. By doing this, they planned to close the gap to the sea, and control a strongly defensible line from one end of the Apsheron Peninsula to the other. The attack failed without artillery support, as the inspector of artillery had not been given warning. As a result of the failure, the remnants of the force retired to a line slightly north of Diga, city of Baku. The oil derricks of Baku shelled during the battle shortly before the Ottoman attack. Russian and Armenian soldiers near the front line. While Baku and its environs had been the site of clashes since June and into mid-August, the term Battle of Baku refers to the operations of 26 August to 14 September. On 26 August, the Ottoman Islamic Army of the Caucasus launched its main attack against positions at the Wolf's Gate. Despite a shortage of artillery, British and Baku troops held the positions against the Army of the Caucasus following the main assault. The Ottoman forces also attacked Binagadi Hill farther north, but also failed after these attacks. Reinforcements were sent to the Balajari station, from where they held the heights to the north. However, faced with increased artillery fire from Ottoman forces, they retired to the railway line. Over the period 28-29 August, the Ottoman forces shelled the city heavily, and attacked the Binagadi Hill position. 500 Ottoman soldiers in close order charged up the hill, but were repulsed with the help of artillery. However, the understrength British troops were forced to retire to positions further south. The 29th of August to the 1st of September, the Ottoman forces managed to capture the positions of Binagadi Hill and Diga. Several coalition units were overrun, and losses were heavy by this point. Allied troops were pushed back to the saucer-like position that made up the heights surrounding Baku. However, Ottoman losses were so heavy that Mersel Bey was not immediately able to continue his offensive. This gave the Baku army invaluable time to reorganize. Faced with an ever-worsening situation, Dunsterville organized a meeting with the Centro-Caspian dictators on 1 September. He said that he was not willing to risk more British lives and hinted at his withdrawal. However, the dictators protested that they would fight to the bitter end, and the British should leave only when troops of the Baku army did. Dunstable decided to stay until the situation became hopeless. Meanwhile, Bicharakov captured Petrovsk, allowing him to send help to Baku. The reinforcements consisting of 600 men from his force, including Cossacks, raised hope. 1-13 September, the Ottoman forces did not attack during this period. The Baku force prepared itself and sent out airplane patrols constantly. In his diary, Dunstable reported the atrocities against the Muslim population perpetrated by Armenian militants on 12 September. An Arab officer from the Ottoman 10th Division deserted, giving information suggesting the main assault would take place on 14 September. On the night of 13-14 September, the Ottoman forces began their attacks. The Ottoman forces nearly overran the strategic Wolf's Gate Azerbaijani, Kurd Kapisi west of Baku, from which the whole battlefield could be seen. However, their advance was halted by a counterattack. The fighting continued for the rest of the day, and the situation eventually became hopeless by the night of 14 September. The remnants of the Baku army and Dunster force evacuated the city for Anzali on 30 October. The armistice of Mudros was signed by the Ottoman Empire. Ottoman forces left the city. Atrocities. March Days. Main article, March Days. On 9 March 1918, the arrest of General Talishinsky, the commander of the Azerbaijani division, and some of its officers, all of whom arrived in Baku, increased the anti-Soviet feelings among the city's Azeri population. On 30 March, based on the unfounded report that the Azerbaijani Muslim crew of the ship Evelina was armed and ready to revolt against the Soviet disarmed the crew who tried to resist. The 3 days of inter-ethnic warfare referred to as the March Days, which resulted in the massacre of up to 12,000 Azerbaijanis by the Bolsheviks and armed Armenian units in the city of Baku and other locations. In the Baku Governorate, the March events, beyond the violent three-day period, touched off a series of massacres all over Azerbaijan. September Days. Main article, September Days. In September 1918, a terrible panic in Baku ensued when the Ottoman Islamic Army of the Caucasus began to enter the city. Armenians crowded the harbor in a frantic effort to escape. Regular Ottoman troops were not allowed to enter the city for 2 days, so that the locally recruited soldiers could massacre non-Muslims. This was permitted as revenge for a massacre of Azeri. In March 1918, it was the last major massacre of World War I. Aftermath. Memorial to the British soldiers in Baku. The British losses in the battle totaled about 200 men and officers killed, missing or wounded. Mersel Bey admitted Ottoman losses of around 2,000 among the civilians. The casualties of Baku's 80,000-person Armenian community were between 9,000 and 10,000, roughly equal to the number of Azeris massacred by Armenians and Bolsheviks during the March Days. Altogether, up to 20,000 Armenians were killed or deported. The capital of the Azerbaijan was finally moved from Ganja to Baku. However, after the armistice of Mudros between the United Kingdom and the Ottoman Empire on October 30, Turkish troops were substituted by the Triple Entente headed by General William Thompson. British troops of 5,000 soldiers, including parts of Dunster Force, arrived in Baku on 17 November, and martial law was implemented on the capital of Azerbaijan Democratic Republic until the civil power would be strong enough to release the forces from the responsibility to maintain the public order. No oil from Baku's oilfields got beyond Tbilisi before the Ottomans and Germans signed the armistice by 16 November. Nuri and Mersel Bey were ejected from Baku, and a British general sailed into the city, headed by one of the ships that had evacuated on the night of 14 September. Memorial in Baku to the Ottoman soldiers who were killed in combat. A memorial in Baku was established to the Ottoman soldiers who were killed in combat. There is also a memorial to the British soldiers in Baku. See also 26 Baku Commissar. Notes. Carat A B C D E F G H I J K L M N O P Q R S T U V W X Y Z A. Ab A C Ad A A F Ag A I A J Ak Al M N Au Ap A Q R Z O Avenue A Ax I Missin 1984, pp. Carat Russian. Michael Smith, Azerbaijan and Russia, Society and State, Traumatic Loss and Azerbaijani National Memory, archived 10 March 2011 at the Wayback Machine. Carat Swedahovsky 2004, pp. Carat Pastormagian 1918, pp. Carat Kopeters, Bruno 1998. Commonwealth and Independence in Post-Soviet Eurasia. Routledge P. World War I Home Fronts Theaters European Balkans Western Front Eastern Front Italian Front Middle Eastern Gallipoli Sinai and Palestine Caucasus Persia Mesopotamia South Arabia African Southwest East Cameroon Togoland North Asian and Pacific Tsingtao German New Guinea and Samoa at Sea North Atlantic U-Boat Campaign Mediterranean North Sea Baltic Indian, Pacific. MASA Tierra Principal Participants People Entente Powers China French Empire Belgium British Empire Greece Italy Japan Montenegro Portugal Romania Russia Russian Empire Russian Republic Serbia United States Central Powers Germany Austria Hungary Ottoman Empire Bulgaria Timeline Pre-war conflicts Scramble for Africa 1880-1914 Russo-Japanese War 1905 First Moroccan Tangier Crisis 1905-06 Agadir Crisis 1911 Italo-Turkish War 1911-12 French Conquest of Morocco 1911-12 First Balkan War 1912-13 Second Balkan War 1913 Prelude Origins Sarajevo assassination anti-Serb riots in Sarajevo July crisis autumn 1914 Battle of the Frontiers Battle of CER First Battle of the Marne Siege of Tsingtao Battle of Tannenberg Battle of Galicia Battle of the Masurian Lakes Battle of Kolubara Battle of Sarakamish Race to the Sea First Battle of Ypres 1915 Second Battle of the Masurian Lakes Second Battle of Ypres Battle of Gallipoli Second Battle of Artois Battles of the Isonzo Great Retreat Second Battle of Champagne Kosovo Offensive Siege of Kut Battle of Luz 1916 Erzurum Offensive Battle of Verdun Lake Narok Offensive Battle of Asiago Battle of Jutland Battle of the Somme Brusilov Offensive Baranovici Offensive Battle of Romani Monastir Offensive Battle of Transylvania 1917 Capture of Baghdad First Battle of Gaza Zimmerman Telegram Second Battle of Aris Kerensky Offensive Third Battle of Ypres Poschendaele Battle of Maricesti Battle of Caporetto Southern Palestine Offensive Battle of Cambrai Armistice of Erzincan 1918 Operation Faustschlag Treaty of Brest-Litovsk Spring Offensive Second Battle of the Marne Battle of Baku 100 Days Offensive Vardar Offensive Battle of Megiddo Third Transjordan Attack Meuse Argonne Offensive Battle of Vittorio Veneto Battle of Aleppo Armistice of Salonika Armistice of Mudros Armistice of Villa Giusti Armistice with Germany Other Conflicts Mexican Revolution 1910-20 Somaliland Campaign 1910-20 Libyan Resistance Movement 1911-43 Meretz Rebellion 1914-15 Zayan War 1914-21 Indo-German Conspiracy 1914-19 Senussi Campaign 1915-16 Volta Boni War 1915-17 Easter Rising 1916 Anglo-Egyptian Darfur Expedition 1916 Khaosan Revolt 1916-17 Russian Revolution 1917 Finnish Civil War 1918 Post-war conflicts Russian Civil War 1917-21 Ukrainian Soviet War 1917-21 Armenian-Azerbaijani War 1918-20 Georgian-Armenian War 1918 German Revolution 1918-19 Revolutions and interventions in Hungary 1918-20 Hungarian-Romanian War 1918-19 Greater Poland Uprising 1918-19 Estonian War of Independence 1918-20 Latvian War of Independence 1918-20 Lithuanian Wars of Independence 1918-20 Third Anglo-Afghan War 1919 Egyptian Revolution 1919 Polish-Ukrainian War 1918-19 Polish-Soviet War 1919-21 Irish War of Independence 1919-21 Turkish War of Independence Greco-Turkish War 1919-23 Turkish-Armenian War 1920 Iraqi Revolt 1920 Polish-Lithuanian War 1920 Vlora War 1920 Franco-Syrian War 1920 Soviet-Georgian War 1921 Irish Civil War 1922-23 Aspects Opposition Pacifism Anti-war movement Deployment Schlieffen Plan German Plan 17 French warfare Military engagements Naval warfare Convoy system Air warfare Cryptography Horse use poison gas Railways Strategic bombing technology Trench warfare Total war Christmas truce Last surviving veterans Civilian impact Atrocities Prisoners Casualties Economic history 1918 Flu pandemic Destruction of Kalish Rape of Belgium German occupation of Belgium German occupation of Luxembourg German occupation of northeastern France Ober-Ost Ottoman people Armenian genocide, Assyrian genocide, Pontic Greek genocide Blockade of Germany. Women. Australia. Popular culture. German prisoners of war in the United States. Agreements. Partitioning of the Ottoman Empire. Sykes-Picot Agreement. Agreement of Saint-Jean-de-Maurienne. French-Armenian Agreement. Damascus Protocol. Paris Peace Conference. Venizelos-Tidoni Agreement. Treaties. Treaty of Brest-Litovsk. Treaty of Lausanne. Treaty of London. Treaty of Neuilly. Treaty of Saint-Germain. Treaty of Sèvres. Treaty of Trianon. Treaty of Versailles. Consequences. Aftermath. 14 points. League of Nations. World War I. Memorials. Centenary. Commemorations. Category. Portal. World War I at Wiktionary. World War I. Textbooks at Wikibooks. World War I. Quotations at Wikiquote. World War I. Source texts at Wikisource. World War I. Images. VE Ottoman Battles in the 20th Century. Italo-Turkish War. 1911-12. Preveza. Tobruk. Kaiwafia. Confuta. Bay. Derna. Beirut. Rhodes. Zanzibar. Balkan Wars. 1912-13. Sarantaporo. Kirkali. Kardjali. Bespinar. Paint. Pigadia. Sarovich. Kamanovo.